It's a double whammy for Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh. He is facing intense attack from within. He appeared before a three-member panel headed by Mallikarjun Kharge to put forward his side of the story on steps being taken to patch up with Navjot Singh Sidhu, who incidentally is not only looking at becoming the Deputy Chief Minister of the state, but also the PCC Chief. Anand Patel and Manjeet Sehgal with our top story.
There are still more than 8 months left for elections in Punjab, but rumblings have already started in the Congress state unit. Chief Minister Amrinder Singh touched down in Delhi to quell dissent within the party in the state. Congress MLAs have been upset with Amrinder Singh, claiming that his government was being run by bureaucrats. The Bargadi sacrilege issue has further divided the ruling party. The Congress High Command has tasked a three-member panel of Mallikarjun Kharge, JP Agarwal and Harish Rawat to resolve the disunity in the party. The panel met with Punjab CM Amrinder Singh as well as MLAs including Navjot Singh Sidhu to sort out the differences.
कई सवाल थे तो वो सवाल हमने मुख्यमंत्री के सामने रखे हैं और मुख्यमंत्री ने कहा है कि वो इसका समाधान निकालेंगे
जो भी कहा जिसने कहा वो उनको बता दिया उन्होंने अपना अपना वो दे दिया जो एक्सप्लेनेशन थी बस
रिपोर्ट तैयार कर रहे हैं आप लोग
हाँ जी हाँ
अच्छा कब तक भेजेंगे हाईकमान को
कल परसों तक भेज देंगे
रिस्पेक्टिंग
The panel is likely to submit a report this weekend to Sonia Gandhi on the rift and in all likelihood there will be changes in the cabinet and in the party.
क्या विचित्र राजनीति चल रही है पूरा पंजाब कोरोना से प्रभावित है आज तो पूरा पंजाब पार्टी और सरकार दिल्ली में है पिछले तीन चार दिन से वह पंजाब को कौन देखेगा
Amrinder is unbending. Ready to fight it out with the Congress High Command, even if it means a split in the party. Before he met the three-member panel in Delhi, the Chief Minister even posed with rebel AAP MLAs Sukhpal Singh Khera and two other legislators who have joined the Congress. But he has not answered any questions on what his game plan is. He is keeping his cards close to his chest.
हमारी छह महीने के अंदर इलेक्शन आ रही है एंड दिस इज इंट्रोस्पेक्शन जो हम अपनी पार्टी में करते हैं और वो ही किया है हमने
द चीफ मिनिस्टर हैज इवन प्रोजेक्टेड हिमसेल्फ एज पंजाब द कैप्टन ऑन हिज फेसबुक पेज सेंडिंग अ क्लियर सिग्नल दैट ही विल बी द सीएम फेस इन द नेक्स्ट इलेक्शंस टू
Four days of peacemaking exercise to quell infighting in Punjab unit has come to an end and the ball rests in the court of party high command. Sources say Badal's escaping charge sheet in the sacrilege case remains the central issue and there's pressure on Captain Amrinder to deliver pre-poll promises as the countdown to 2022 polls has begun. With camera person Helen, this is Anand Patel in New Delhi for India Today.
Joining me on the broadcast from the Congress Party is Supriya Srinath. Sanju Verma represents the Bharatiya Janata Party. Our National Affairs Editor Rahul Srivastav also with me. But before I come to our guests, the opposition that's come out all guns blazing, targeting the Punjab Congress government, accusing it of profiteering from the pandemic. Vaccines that the state government bought for 400 rupees were sold to private hospitals at 1,060 rupees. These private hospitals then charged people up to 1,700 rupees. Union Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar says this is sin. Sukhbir Badal wants the state health minister sacked, even though under intense pressure, the order stands withdrawn. Manjeet Sehgal reports. Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh is in the line of fire over an alleged vaccine scam in the state. Opposition, Bharatiya Janata Party, Shiromani Akali Dal and the Aam Aadmi Party have launched a scathing attack on the Punjab government on acquiring coronavirus vaccines from vaccine manufacturers at 400 rupees a jab and then selling it to private hospitals at 1,060 rupees per dose, making a profit of 660 rupees per dose. Private hospitals in turn stand accused of charging people in the state anything between 1,500 to 1,700 a dose, thereby making a profit of more than 550 rupees a dose. Union Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar accused the Congress of trying to make a profit from the pandemic.
कोविन जैसे वैक्सीनेशन में भी वो राज्य सरकार प्रॉफिट ही कमाना चाहती है तो ये कैसा जनता का प्रशासन है?
In Punjab, Sukhbir Singh Badal of the Shiromani Akali Dal sought the dismissal of the state health minister Balbir Singh and a probe by a sitting High Court judge into what he described was Punjab's vaccine scam.
Captain Amarinder Singh, ऐस बीमारी तो पैसा कमाउन लगे लोगों की जाना परवाह नहीं पर पैसे सरकार पैसा बनाउन लग गई ते अपने चहेतियां नू पैसा कमाउन दा साधन बनाता.
The opposition has hit out at what Badal called was hypocrisy of the Congress party seeking free vaccination for all and then selling vaccines to make a hefty profit. The Aam Aadmi Party too attacked the Congress government in the state for allegedly profiteering from the pandemic.
हमने ये सुना था कि राज्य सरकारें वैक्सीन के लिए पैसा इकट्ठा करती हैं, लेकिन ये पहली बार सुन रहे हैं कि एक राज्य सरकार वैक्सीन से पैसा बना रही है, पैसा इकट्ठा कर रही है.
The opposition even accused the state government of acting as agents of private hospitals after Punjab Chief Secretary tweeted the cost and availability of vaccines at two major private hospitals. Under intense opposition fire, the Punjab Health Minister Balbir Singh announced the decision, taking back the order to sell vaccines at a profit to private hospitals.
जो हमारा बजट सेशन था उसमें सबसे पहले उन्होंने बोला सबको ये जो वैक्सीन है फ्री लगाई जाएगी तो फ्री लगाने का हमारा जो फैसला वो अटल है तो इसलिए जो कोई फैसला हुआ कल आज उसको हमने वापस ले लिया.
But the opposition remains unsparing, saying there should be an investigation into vaccine administration in Congress-run states of Punjab, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan.
Punjab government has taken a U-turn on selling vaccines in the private hospitals. Amid the mounting pressure from the opposition, the government now says that it will provide vaccines for free to the people. As there is a united call for a probe into the alleged scam of jabs by opposition parties, including Shiromani Akali Dal, Bharatiya Janata Party, and Aam Aadmi Party. With video journalist Dilip Sahu, this is Manjit Sehgal in Chandigarh for India Today.
Supriya Srinath, Rahul Gandhi advocates free vaccination, and yet the Congress procures vaccines at 400 rupees, sells it to private hospitals at 1,000 rupees, that administer them for up to 1,700 rupees. Opposition says the Congress does not practice what it preaches.
I entirely lambast what the opposition is saying on this, and I will, with all honesty and with my hand on my heart, I will say, it was an inverted error, and that error should have been avoided. These vaccines should not have gone to the private hospitals. But a sensitive government does what? We immediately withdrew that order. We will compensate the people who have paid higher. And we have also ordered an inquiry as to how this administrative order was made. That is what sensitive governments do. What do insensitive governments do? They create multiple price slabs. Look, what is the basis of the problem? And I'm not going to, you know, play a political blame game here. The genesis of the problem is that India is the only country in the world where there is more than one price for vaccine being administered. There are five different slabs. Even in a city like Delhi, there is 1,200, 1,500, 2,000. In UP, vaccines and in private hospitals are being administered for 1,500 bucks. All I'm saying is, whether it is Congress, whether it is BJP, the strategy, and the Supreme Court has questioned the government, called it arbitrary and irrational, and they have said this arbitrary pricing will have to stop. And this arbitrary pricing is because The government has left it to the states, left them in a lurch to procure their vaccines, to do what they want. And now they are going around doing a U-turn on vaccine manufacturing, on compulsory licensing, and also on foreign vaccination.
Fair enough. Let me bring in Sanju Verma.
Absolutely.
Let me bring in Sanju Verma.
But we have withdrawn.
Hold on. Let's keep this conversational. Sanju Verma, the Congress says the order stands withdrawn. The money will be refunded. This is not a scam. Centers responsible for arbitrary pricing of vaccines.
Gaurav, you know, first and foremost, I just want to say one very important thing, and that is that today the discussion is not about what the Modi government is doing. Today it is about the malafide intent with which the Punjab government under the leadership of Amrinder Singh was shamelessly trying to profiteer from selling vaccines to private hospitals, point number one. Only after the media outrage, the order to sell vaccines at a profit to private hospitals was withdrawn. Point number three, and very importantly, you know, I keep hearing this data being thrown at BJP leaders about how we mismanaged COVID. So I want to tell you one thing, and this is out in the public domain. All the Congress-ruled states together, put together, the COVID fatality rate in Congress-ruled states is 277 per million. In BJP-governed states, it's 133 per million. And more importantly, speaking of Punjab, which is the topic of your debate today, Gaurav, what is the national fatality rate of COVID in India? The lowest in the world at 1.1%. What is the COVID fatality rate in Punjab? The latest figures say the COVID fatality rate in Punjab is 2.4%, more than double the fatality rate in India. So you can imagine the kind of pathetic mishandling. Just one last point. What is the population of Punjab, Gaurav? The population of Punjab is barely 3 crores. Okay? Which means that the population of Punjab...
Ma'am, you're saying it's pathetic mishandling. That's your point. Ma'am, I have to give equal time to all our guests. Permit me to moderate. You've made one point. I'll come back to you for your second point. But let me bring in Rahul Srivastav into this conversation. Rahul Srivastav, has Punjab actually taken the wind out of the opposition attack on government, on free vaccination or differential pricing, the way 400 rupee vaccine was being sold at 1000 rupees to private hospitals and was being administered at 1700 rupees to people, Rahul?
Gaurav, at 8 p.m. in our sister channel's program, the Congress spokesperson admitted it was a mistake, and it was a mistake that decisions should have been taken. Now, the fact is that if the mistake has happened, say, for example, Nirmala Sitharaman on March 31st, the finance ministry cleared a cut in interest rate, small savings, and it was said that it was an inadvertent error. Did the opposition accept it? No, it didn't. It blamed the finance minister. Now, by the same yardstick, if a Babu or a bureaucrat or anybody takes a decision, it's not God of something ordinary we are dealing with. It is something that we know, the Prime Minister should know, Rahul Gandhi knows, that vaccine is life and death.
Yes.
In that scenario, if we talk about that the center delayed the vaccination procurement and today we are facing shortages, in the same speed, in the same vein, what one can say that this was a terrible decision. And this is perhaps running the entire vaccination drive aground, Gaurav, because Mr. Naveen Patnaik, if he says center should procure centrally, states should be free to distribute it.
Okay.
Now, at every level, if there is a mess, where should the public go? One more small point. Gaurav, when it is being said that there is a multiple pricing thing happening, when on 22nd April, the Chief Minister of Punjab said there will be free vaccination.
Yes.
Punjab gives 16,500 crore as electricity subsidy every year. That state can afford 5.8 crore vaccines at 2,800 crore very easily.
Oh, absolutely.
Why is there pricing? Why is it being sold to anybody?
And that is something Supriya Srinath. Was it a mistake? Or, as the withdrawal order also says, that it wasn't taken in the right spirit. Supriya Srinath, Shiromani Akali Dal leader Manjinder Singh Sirsa says that the Shiromani Gurdwara Prabandhak Committee purchases vaccines at 1,000 rupees and then gives it free to people. He accuses the Congress of doing just the opposite and says the Amrinder Singh government is being corrupt here when they charge a hefty profit even during this pandemic, madam.
I will answer your question, but I will also clarify what Rahul Srivastav just said. When he said we blame the FM, Rahul, we blame the FM because the RTI has revealed that the final file for cutting of rates on small-scale savings was cleared by the finance minister. It was her signature that cleared that cut, and eventually she said it was an inadvertent error, and we've glossed over it now. The reality is it was her signature that cleared it. Having said that, vaccine is life and death, absolutely, and which is why we are wondering, why has India's vaccination drive fallen by 80% from its peak? We were vaccinating 42 lakh people a day.
Okay, you're
Supriya Srinath. That's
exactly Supriya Srinath, my questions are very specific.
I am sorry.
Ma'am, you have to be specific.
I am coming back to that question. Yes.
Shiromani Gurdwara Prabhandak Committee gives free vaccines. They pay for it and give it free to people. The Punjab government has done just the opposite. Ma'am, let Ms. Srinath finish.
You.
I'll come to you.
Yeah. Gaurav, may I give a rebuttal?
In 2 minutes. Just let Supriya finish. Ma'am, no, one by one, please. Let Supriya finish. I'll come to you, please.
Gaurav, when Uttar Pradesh says we are going to vaccinate people free, they are talking about Sarkari vaccination free hoga. Private vaccination kisi ka bhi free nahi ho raha. Private.
Again, you are going away from the topic. Nahi, Supriya Srinath. Supriya Srinath, my question was very specific.
No.
400 rupees ki vaccine, 1700 mein lag rahi hai.
Government vaccination.
Gaurav, may I come and make my rebuttal?
Gaurav Sawant,
this cannot be a complete
one by one. Sanju, give me a moment. Let Supriya Srinath come finish. I'll come to you.
No, Gaurav. Gaurav, I am trying to clarify.
Gaurav, she has
that
spoken
one by one. Ma'am, please permit her to complete.
In government nobody needs pre-vaccination in private hospitals. Tell her to have some medicine, not to hyperventilate.
No, hold on.
You will be given a chance. Don't hyperventilate. You will be given a chance.
I don't need lectures from you, Supriya. You're the last
we are
person
talking
who should lecture
government
me.
Vaccination. Every state says government vaccination. Keep quiet, please. Please keep quiet. I know you hyperventilate.
Ma'am, allow me to moderate, please.
I don't need lectures from you. Stop giving me a bhashan.
Hold on. No personal attacks, please. I am sorry, Supriya Srinath. I am sorry. That's unacceptable, madam. I am sorry, madam.
Supriya Srinath, my question to you is very specific.
It is an Amrinder Singh government. Charging, you know, 1,000 rupees for an injection for which it has paid 400 rupees. Please respond to that, ma'am. You're talking about Uttar Pradesh, you're talking about Madhya Pradesh, you're talking about every state except Punjab.
No. I will come to you for your rebuttal.
Sanju Verma, let her complete. I will come to you and I will not let her interrupt. Go on, Supriya Srinath. I have to finish my point.
Please give this woman some water.
Hold on.
Tell her to relax. When any government, whether it's Punjab, Delhi, or state government, when they say free vaccination, they are talking about this. They are talking about government hospitals. Nobody is talking about private hospitals. Yes, it was an error, and that error has been withdrawn. But what about the PPE kit scam that happened in Himachal Pradesh?
Are you saying that these vaccines were not meant for free distribution? Were these not meant for free distribution? Because your health minister says Punjab government will administer vaccines free.
Gaurav.
But your government is charging a profit.
Hold on.
Sanju Verma wants to come in. Sanju Verma wants to come in, and only Sanju Verma, just now, please.
We are also
only Sanju Verma.
People who have paid for this. She can hyperventilate.
No, I'm sorry. Okay, only Sanju Verma, please respond, ma'am. No, Supriya Srinath, only Sanju Verma now. Please respond, ma'am.
Okay. Gaurav, thank you. Gaurav, I just want to put a couple of things out as a matter of record. The topic of discussion today is Punjab. I told you that despite being a small state with a population of 3 crores, can you imagine, Gaurav, it has reported over 5.74 lakh infections. The COVID mortality rate in Punjab at 2.4% is more than double the national average of 1.1%. which is shameful and showcases the pathetic leadership of Amrinder Singh. More importantly, the national recovery rate of COVID today in India is 93%, whereas the recovery rate in Punjab is only 86%. So even the recovery rate is a good 7% below the national recovery rate. And I want to say one thing, Gaurav. This whole narrative about, you know, procuring vaccines at different prices, Serum Institute will give vaccines to central and state government hospitals at 300 rupees per dose. Bharat Biotech will give it to central and state government hospitals at 400 rupees a dose. Now tell me, Gaurav, 300 to 400 rupees a dose, assuming a rupee dollar exchange rate of 73, basically means that in India, we are giving vaccines to people at between $4 to $5.5.
No, but on
Supriya
today's
Srinath,
topic,
who has no clue about
on today's topic,
economy,
Sanju Verma,
and only comes and abuses.
Congress says
the
they've done mid-course correction.
Say, I will pay 1500 rupees for Pfizer, which you get in the United States. A single dose is $20, and you need three doses. That means $60. So they don't mind paying $60, but they have a problem paying $4 to Serum and problem paying $5.5.
Okay, I'll get Supriya Srinath to respond to that.
Point.
I'll get her to respond.
Point.
Ma'am, take my question. Take my question. That was your rebuttal to Supriya Srinath. Hold on.
The wastage rate is highest in Congress states.
I'll come to that point. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Step by step, ma'am. Sanju Verma, hold on. I asked Supriya Srinath to hold on at that point of time. Now is the time. Both of you speaking simultaneously will not help anyone.
Okay.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Sanju Verma and Supriya Srinath. Hold on for a moment, please. Sanju Verma, my question is very specific.
I'm sorry, Gaurav. I am very sorry.
Okay. My request is, I am sorry, you have to hear me out. You have to hold, no personal attacks will be permitted. I am sorry. That will derail the debate. That is not permitted. Supriya Srinath, uncalled for, unwarranted, and not required. I am sorry. Sanju Verma, the Congress has done mid-course correction under intense public and opposition pressure. Sanju Verma, you have to hear me out. Congress says this is what a democracy is, unlike the BJP. Unlike BJP, I'm sorry, Sanju Verma, you're not hearing me. You're not hearing me. I'm sorry. Okay, I'm going to go to Rahul Srivastava. What is the point? What are you guys doing? Trying to earn brownie points in your respective offices? Let the viewers benefit. Speak one by one, please. My request to you.
I'm not even talking. Keep short. What rubbish.
No, I'm sorry, Supriya Srinath. That language is unacceptable. Supriya Srinath, I should not be able to...
I wasn't talking.
Even to my guests on my show,
you
that language is.
Everybody with the same brand.
I am sorry, no, such no, language is no, unacceptable in polite circles. I will not accept this language on my show. Let's be very clear about that, Supriya Srinath. I am sorry. You've been an anchor yourself. You will not permit any of your guests to speak to the other guests like that. I'm sorry, unacceptable.
You cannot put my audio down. You cannot tell me to shut up.
I will not put anybody's audio down, but I will bring in Rahul Srivastava. Rahul, is there merit in the government saying that the Congress and the opposition parties are indulging in politics of misleading people? States and opposition first asked to decentralize the process. When that process was decentralized, the states are saying, let the center go and acquire and the states will distribute.
Gaurav, it's a huge cumulative, collective mess created right since the first day and the first case of COVID was reported. Lockdown came in, lockdown was called bad, the economy tanked. It was said that the government, central government, brought the economy down. People were against lockdowns. Then now there are demands for lockdowns. 98% India was under virtual restriction lockdowns. And while the last lockdown was criticized, the central government, which went for lockdown, this time didn't do anything. Vaccinations came, Gaurav. From the very first day, there were doubts that this government, which was batting for vaccination, failed to procure vaccines. Gaurav, it's a huge collective mess. What political parties don't realize, people are dying. And at the end, when the vote is put, the public will hyperventilate. And that's what they should be afraid, Gaurav. In the market today, there is a debate, say in the GST Council, there are people looking for, states looking for vaccinations to be made tax-free.
Yes.
That the 5%, which invites actually brings in input tax credit, should be removed. If you are wanting that the 5% taxes should be removed and you want to charge a profit on the cost price of a vaccine. Even if private was going to sell more, why is a government deciding to take a margin while it is selling it to a private entity?
And
that means,
and in that order,
the 85 lakh vaccines which could have gone free to the poor,
yes,
have gone to the rich.
Yes, that's the point. That's the point. One by one, my request once again. My request once again to both my guests. Yes, ma'am. I want both of you to come in one by one. But my request is, please, one by one. There are people who are watching this. Let them walk away with something from this bulletin. And Supriya Srinath, Sukhbir Badal says, Balbir Singh Sidhu, the health minister, should quit because he says this is blatant corruption and profiteering from the pandemic. Sidhu says that this decision was taken by bureaucrats. That's again a complaint against the chief minister. Are bureaucrats running the Punjab government, ma'am?
So Gaurav Sawant, I'm going to give you a very simple reply on this. And if you heard my first answer, I started off by saying, I put my hand on my heart and say, it was an error, shouldn't have happened, it has been withdrawn, people will be compensated. And this is something that we need to move on from here, should not have
with
happened
due
in the
respect,
first place. However,
if you see the withdrawal order, that withdrawal order
thing.
Does not say,
no,
we are
finish,
sorry,
please.
That withdrawal
please
order does not
finish.
Say it was a mistake. It was said, the withdrawal order says it wasn't taken in the right spirit. My humble submission, but go on, ma'am.
Okay, let me finish. I think the finance, I think the health minister has come on record and said, I'm ordering an inquiry. And, you know, I think we have to believe an elected representative there. However, I would want to point out here that whether, you know, this should have happened or not happened, it should not have happened in the first place. The vaccines did not go out of Punjab. I agree that this should have been given to the poor, given at free of cost. This did not go out of Punjab, unlike the 6.5 crore that we exported to the rest of the world without vaccinating our own people. And only 16% of that was under diplomacy. The rest of it, 84%, was commercial contract. I really want to ask, what is the government's
Gaurav,
response
may I please?
To
the
Ravi
moment
Shankar
she finishes,
Prasad's
ma'am,
statement
and then
that
I will
we
not
are
let
lobbying
her
for
interrupt.
Pharma companies? Today they are... To,
go on, ma'am.
Today,
yes,
the government has taken a moral high ground and said in its letter, we are allowing more foreign companies, we are allowing more compulsory licenses. Why did you waste 1.5 months? And why did you ridicule the Indian opposition, especially the Congress, when
fair
we
enough.
Gave you both
You've
these
made your point.
Which are now coming from the Supreme Court?
Fair
why
enough.
Are you not
I need
taking
to
action
okay.
against... Let me finish. Why
now,
are you not taking
now,
action
now
against
Sanju
somebody
responds.
Like Ramdev, who's on record
may
to say...
Ma'am, Ramdev is not a part... Hold on. Baba, Ramdev is not a part of this debate. Go on. Okay. Ma'am, you've made your point. Now, please hear Sanju Verma's response. Go on, ma'am.
Gaurav, first and foremost, you know, I don't want to make this abusive, but I think the Congress, including Supriya Srinath, they are mathematically challenged. They keep spewing lies. 22 crore plus people have been given the first dose, assuming an adult population of 94 crore. It means that we have vaccinated 23% of our adult population.
Hold on,
Supriya Srinath,
you are not a backbencher, don't behave like one.
16% of our total population. One more thing, Gaurav, please.
Yes,
Gaurav,
go on,
please.
Only Sanju Verma, please.
Okay.
Go on, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So, Gaurav, the fact of the matter is, if you assume that we have vaccinated with the first dose 22 crore people, we have vaccinated 23% of India's adult population and 16% of our total population, point number one. Point number two, I also want to say we vaccinated more than 90% of our healthcare workers. And Gaurav, you will be very happy to know that we have vaccinated 22 crore people with the first dose in record 135 days. It has taken US 167 days to vaccinate 22 crore people. So
okay.
All these Congressies who keep saying Modi Sarkar has taken a long time to vaccinate people have completely lost the plot. Supriya said we should believe the Punjab health minister because he's an elected representative. Excuse me, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has won with a thumping mandate twice. Your party was reduced to a piddly
okay.
44 in 2014
question,
and 52 in 2019. Do you believe Prime Minister Modi? You don't believe him.
Okay.
Do you believe Prakash Jawhekar? You don't believe him.
Yes.
Do you believe Ravi Shankar Prasad? You don't believe
I want to bring in Ram Srivastav for a moment.
You don't believe her.
Okay.
But we should believe your Punjab
can
health minister.
Can I please come in?
Who
okay.
are you trying
Ram
to fool, Supriya? Punjab has
no, we should believe you. We should believe
no,
you.
No, hold on. So,
we should believe the joke and the lie.
You know, while I quite enjoy friendly banter, unfortunately, this isn't friendly banter. And Rahul Srivastav, opposition in Punjab is saying, and I will keep this debate on Punjab today, it says that the order, which has since withdrawn, was discriminatory against rural Punjab. Cheaper vaccines should have gone to villages of Punjab where the problem is big instead of being sold to posh hospitals at a hefty profit. Merit in that criticism, Rahul.
Yes, Gaurav, there is a crisis because if you see in the last two months, more cases have come in from deep rural areas, Punjab. Now, not only they haven't got access to vaccine, remember, they have poorer access to health facilities. An urban area is much better provided in terms of health than rural areas. Captain Amrinder Singh and we have been in touch with the government. They are making a lot of efforts in that area to bring better health facilities. But the fact is that if the bureaucracy is managing this, Gaurav, it's a telling commentary. 85 lakh vaccines going away from the rural first to urban setup is a reflection on the health minister.
Yes.
Also, if you see corruption and a lot of these charges, which is the opposition may be making today, Gaurav, but I think today the Congress party in Punjab and the corruption charges against the government are more in news because of charges by congressmen like Navjot Singh Sidhu and others.
Yes.
The incompetence being called by people like Navjot Singh Sidhu and others is more in talk, so much so that in the middle of a COVID battle, Captain Amrinder Singh had to come to Delhi to depose before a three-member committee. So it's a telling commentary, Gaurav.
It indeed is.
Same happened with ventilators.
Yes.
That sometime between 6th of October to 28th, ventilators were not distributed. The bureaucracy is having a greater say.
Supriya Srinath, that's the point. Punjab's chief secretary, she stands accused of acting as an agent of private hospitals, directing people to private hospitals through social media messages instead of perhaps sending more and more resources to government hospitals and for rural vaccination. Then again, the criticism that Navjot Singh Sidhu sends Captain Amrinder Singh's ways, will this impact Captain Amrinder Singh adversely in your view, ma'am?
No, before I answer that, I think I want to place one figure on the record just for your viewers and let them decide what's happening in Punjab. Punjab, like it was rightly pointed out in this debate, has a population of about 2.8 crore to 3 crore. They have vaccinated 51.5 lakh people with first dose. And the second dose has been given to 7,84,000 people. That's the level at which vaccination is happening in Punjab. It is a population of 2.8 crore.
One by one.
I will start shouting. Is this how we're going to debate?
Nope.
I'm putting out a figure. Please listen.
Go on, Supriya Srinath.
So Punjab, with a population of 2.8 to 3 crore, has vaccinated 51.5 lakh people with the first dose, second dose given to almost 8 lakh people. Uttar Pradesh, with 10 times the population, actually even more, has vaccinated only 1.94 crore people and only 35 lakh people in Uttar Pradesh vaccinated with the second dose. I'm just coming back from Uttar Pradesh. I was in my village for the last few days. There is no vaccination that's happening there, but that's besides the point. I want to say that at least a state is vaccinating. Should they be doing it for the poor first? Absolutely, the resources need to go
Should
to the poor.
Should they be profiteering from the pandemic?
Afford, you know, is the debate today?
But okay, you say that point is taken. Sanju Verma, you want to quickly respond to the point that she's making?
So let me,
Punjab is vaccinating.
Let me finish. No, let me finish. Gaurav,
quickly.
I have just
30 seconds left on the broadcast, please. Sanju Verma, to quickly respond to this.
I am just sending.
Sanju Verma.
I am 1 second. Surya has found profiteering.
No, hold on. We've covered that. We've covered all of that. No, we've covered all of that. We've covered all of that. You've been on my show when we've covered those stories.
Now,
I'm sorry. You were there on my show when we've covered those stories. Now you're not. I'm sorry. Okay. Only Sanju Verma.
I really want to know.
Sanju Verma.
No, I'm letting her speak. I am not.
Yes, Sanju Verma, respond.
Gaurav, thank you. Thank you so much. Gaurav, you know, people keep talking about Uttar Pradesh. I just want to say one thing, Gaurav. Uttar Pradesh has a population of 24 crore. A population equal to a country like Brazil, because everybody seems to be comparing Uttar Pradesh with Brazil these days. Brazil has reported close to 5 lakh deaths. And while every life counts, Uttar Pradesh has had a phenomenal, you know, turnaround. The test positivity rate today is so low. And, you know, the number of deaths have been reined in at less than 21,000. So, please stop comparing Uttar Pradesh and Punjab. I just want to say one thing, Gaurav. That the Congress party keeps saying Modi government did not do this, did not do that. Who created vaccine hesitancy? It was the Bhupesh Baghel government in Chhattisgarh ruled by the Congress. Who's thrown 11 and a half lakh vaccine vials into the dustbin?
In case they've actually thrown 11.5 lakh vaccines,
then... Who has the highest COVID mortality rate in a state like Punjab? More than twice the national average. So Supriya Srinath can come here and keep giving bhashan. I just want to complete by asking one thing. So many questions are asked, Gaurav, of Narendra Modi. Tell me honestly with your hand on your heart. Can Supriya Srinath tell
that Rahul Gandhi
even said
because there's a high population, you will not vaccinate them?
Ma'am, we are asking questions to the center. We are asking questions to the state. It's our job to ask questions and we will continue to ask questions.
No, I'm asking.
Okay, but, today I've run out of time on this part of the show. This time I've run out of time on this part of the show. We will track the story very closely. Sanju Verma, Supriya Srinath and Rahul Srivastav, many thanks for joining me. The Delhi High Court has dismissed a petition of actor Juhi Chawla on 5G technology, saying that the petitioners had abused